I've been a builder since I was born. I think I was handed a milk bottle and the first thing I did was unscrewed it to see why milk come out of it rather than drink the milk from it. That's who I am. My name's John Mangiacaro. My title is Instructional Media Analyst. I also manage the Makerspace. I was one of the lead facilitators that was called upon to create and help build the Makerspace. People that know me, that see me in this position, think this place is you. A couple administrators thought, you know, we should think about making a hackerspace for the university. And we decided, well, let's get a 3D printer. We bought a small printer and a laser engraver. And I think the third item I bought was the Gigabot. I go, listen, there's a printer that's like huge. And they go, well, we gotta get one. The Makerspace was born. Our grand opening was October 14th, 2014. And we've been here ever since. The Makerspace is all free and it's open for all faculty, students, and staff. Give all those people an opportunity to come do stuff that you normally wouldn't be able to do unless you're in maybe engineering or architecture or fashion. We have all the tools that a lot of those schools have and maybe even more. This place is visited by a wide variety, wide spectrum. I think the coolest thing about it is the cross-pollination that occurs here. That someone may come to the university for 4 years and never run into someone else. Someone in fashion may never run into someone in law or management or architecture or aerospace or biomedical. The Makerspace combines all those people and all those interests together. One of the first students that came here, she was designing a product and heard about the Makerspace. She was going out to a local design firm. She wasn't sure exactly how the product was going to turn out, so she went through a lot of different changes to her product, which was very costly because she was having, you know, engineers draw it up and having a design made and a prototype done. Well, she heard about the Makerspace. She called me up one day and says, I hear you, can you guys make prototypes of like files? I go, sure. She came in at 10 o'clock in the morning. By 3 in the afternoon, I gave her prototypes of her file. She could not believe it. I said, here's 10 of them. She gave it to friends of hers to get feedback. And she stayed for the next 3 months getting it perfected. We worked together. We did get it to exactly how she wanted. Then she went back to the engineering firm, and now they were able to just make the product and production level model. She kept telling me she's going to be on Shark Tank someday, and she's going to come by and buy me the next biggest machine I want.